Hola a todos. In this video, we're going to talk about how to do basic arithmetic operations in MATLAB. Here we see a short list of symbols for those basic arithmetic operations. Addition is the plus symbol, subtraction the minus, multiplication is the star, or in other words, shift 8. We have in MATLAB actually two types of division. One of them is called right division, which you've seen in most of your classes, and the other is called left division, which is very, very special to MATLAB. We're gonna go way deeper in this in future lessons. There's also exponentiation and negation. So an example of, let's say, multiplication, if I wanted to do 7 times 4, I could type that in this way. Right division is kind of standard. If I did 8 right divide 4, so that would be 8 divided by 4. But if I did 8 left divide 4, that would take the thing on the right and divide it by the thing on the left, or in some sense, invert the thing on the left, multiply that inverse by the right-hand side. In other words, that's 1/2, or 4 left divide 8 would be 2. Exponentiation we've seen also. If I did 8 to the 4th power, we have also seen negation. If I wanted to do -5, that gives me a negative value of 5. This list of operations actually is not at all exhaustive. It's a short list to get us started. This is where I want to point out one of the major themes of this course, which is I want to help you learn how to teach yourself. My job as a teacher is to get myself fired. If you know how to teach yourself coding and how to learn MATLAB, you'll never need me, which is really exciting. With that in mind, let's go up to the resources button and hit the little downward arrow. Do you see the little help symbol? Let's go down in that arrow and hit documentation. That will bring up this documentation center, which has a ton of information. One of the things that you could do to learn everything that I've shown you thus far in these videos is actually to read through this. We're talking about MATLAB in this course, so let's go ahead and click on the MATLAB symbol. Notice that immediately up here is a long list of subjects that I can read about. In this case, we're talking about a subset of mathematics called arithmetic. Let's go ahead and click on mathematics. Then we ask ourselves, which of the topics listed in this subject in the documentation is most relevant? Am I talking about elementary math, linear algebra, random number generators? Well, this is, of course, elementary operations or arithmetic operations. I would guess that it's in elementary math. Let's go ahead and click that. Indeed, this is what we call arithmetic operations, the first one in my list. So let's go ahead and click on that. And we see that this gives me a sense of the different basic arithmetic. We had the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. And I see that I have both left and right division. I also have powers and transposes. Don't get too lost in this documentation. What I wanted to show you is that we can find support for the operations that we're doing. Notice here that MATLAB is claiming that I can use the plus sign, and if I click on that, it will give me some syntax. How am I to use this? And notice this, that plus sign also has a function realization. So if I click on this, C equals plus parentheses A comma B is an alternative way to execute A plus B. It is rarely used, but it enables overloading. So in other words, if I go back to my command window and I write plus, and I want to do 5 and 7, this will allow me to add 5 plus 7. Kind of useful to read through that. There is a ton of information on that documentation. We'll talk more about how to use this. The point of this conversation is to say, as we're getting our head around basic arithmetic operations, it is useful to know where corresponding documentation sits in the MATLAB help environment. The next thing we're going to talk about is operator precedence. To do that, let me go ahead and maximize my command window. So that's the only thing I'm looking at. I'm going to type a command that kind of has some interesting notation. So let's do -5 squared plus 14 divided by 7 times 2. One question that I have for you viewers is, what is the output of this command going to be? Pause this video and see if you can predict the output. Now that you've done that, let's go ahead and execute. Notice that this output reflects what we call PEMDAS in mathematics. In corresponding coding language, we would call that operator precedence. In other words, when MATLAB is faced with this string of symbols, literally there's a negative sign, then a 5, then an exponent, then a 2, plus 14 divided by 7 times 2, it has to actually interpret what that string means. To do so, it uses operator precedence. Let's go ahead and search the documentation for operator precedence, which we type in this little search query box at the top. When we push enter on that, MATLAB is going to come up with a search of its own documentation. Notice that the top entry of that search is the exact search query that I use. Once I click that item, a very nice article in MATLAB documentation comes up that describes how MATLAB uses precedence rules. I'm gonna let you all read that on your own. Please do read this. This is worth your time. Notice though that the rules for precedence in MATLAB are shown in the list below. So the highest precedent, the thing that gets executed first, shows up in parentheses. Then we have either transposes, powers, or matrix powers, which are done at the next level of precedence, and then on down. Let's see if we can use this list of precedence in the documentation to see how MATLAB is parsing this code. So let's look at all the different operations involved. Here we have a unary minus. That means that I'm taking whatever's on the right-hand side of that minus sign and then making it negative. Here I have an exponent, then I have, or a power, then I have a plus, division, and a times. Which of those comes first? Well, if we look, number 2, powers are of highest precedence out of all lists. So the first thing that's going to get executed is 5 squared. So that first bit is 25. If I look right down here, we have unary minus. So the next thing that's going to happen internally in MATLAB is MATLAB's going to take that 25 and make it negative. So the first thing that happens in this execution is the 5 gets squared and then turns negative. The next thing that's going to happen, well, we're not sure about the plus yet, but we know that division and multiplication and division happen on the same order. So first, 14 is going to get divided by 7, which ends up to be 2. And then 14 divided by 7, if that is 2, when I multiply by 2 again, that's going to get 4. So now I have negative 25, then I have 4 on this side, and then the last order of operations, well, notice that the addition comes under all of those. So if I said negative 25 plus 4, the output would be negative 21. Let's go ahead and push the up arrow and go back to the original claim. Notice that when I execute that code, indeed, negative 21 comes out. And the reason that happens comes from the precedence rules internally in MATLAB. We're going to talk more about the names of these operations, this kind of specialized computer language or computer jargon. But the point is, when I type MATLAB code, it is useful to know what the operations go like. To be honest with you, I do not like this written code. If I wrote this myself, I would feel like I should be fired from my job. It is much more helpful if I use what I call parentheses to say, hey, the first thing I'm going to do is take 5 and square it. Then I'd like to take the output of that and put a negative on it. I'm also going to take 14 divided by 7. I'm going to take the output of that operation and multiply by 2. And then I'm gonna add the output of the first set of operations to the output of the second set of operations, which I can see by adding these parentheses. When I execute that code, notice that I get a negative 21, but the parentheses give me a lot more information about which operation is happening in which order. The major takeaway from all this conversation is, one of the main principles we're going to work with is using MATLAB documentation and other resources that we have at our fingertips to teach ourselves how to code and how MATLAB is working. This is a very, very important principle in scientific computation and in learning how to use computers. Much of the work historically that has been done has been self-taught because society at large is still quite young in the development of computation. The first computer was made in the 1945, and specifically, computation really didn't hit the mainstream, I would say, until like the 80s. And we are still getting our head around how to teach this stuff. In the meantime, as you're going through your education, I think it's super important that you learn how to teach yourself. In MATLAB, the documentation is a great way to do that. For the last part of this video, I want to teach you a useful debugging trick. This goes to my larger focus in my classes on developing good habits from an early start. I have this saying that I love to use: bad habits are easy to form, but hard to live with. Good habits are hard to form, but easy to live with. In other words, sometimes we do things not because we're thinking about it, just because it's convenient, and that causes a lot of issues later in our life. If instead we spend a little bit of consciousness in the early stages and develop a well-targeted strategic habit, it takes more time up front, but it saves us a lot of pain in the back end. That principle is in play in this next trick. Anytime we do an open parentheses, I'm going to make a suggestion, also do a closed parentheses. So pretend I wanted to add 12 and 24 and then divide 5 and 7, 5 plus 7. Open parentheses, the moment I type that open parentheses, I'm immediately going to end it with the closed parentheses and then go back inside that set, 5 plus 7, in order to define the denominator of that division. The reason that that's really useful is if I just type along and do a bunch of operations inside this thing, and then perhaps I don't remember that I was doing this, and then I divide by 4 plus 5, it may be the case that I forget to close this. And in fact, in my history as a coder, I think I spent probably 12 to 16 hours, I forget, trying to find a closed parentheses sign. I didn't know it at the time. One way to avoid that is that the moment that I enter the open parentheses sign, immediately type the closed parentheses sign and then go back inside those parentheses to define what operation that I'm trying to do. I implore you all at home to spend the little bit of extra time developing this habit. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Last call that we're going to make, notice that this error MATLAB found itself and then it suggested some code to me. So let's pretend that I opened a parentheses sign and then I didn't close it. MATLAB will suggest what it thinks I mean. That's kind of an auto correction. The way to avoid this type of scenario is just anytime I write an open symbol, immediately write a closed symbol after that fact. Then I'm not having to worry about it. That concludes this video where we've taken a look at basic arithmetic operations in MATLAB. We also opened MATLAB documentation for the first time and saw how to do a few easy searches to learn information about operator precedence as well as the arithmetic operation symbols. And we've gotten our first debugging tool, which is anytime we wrote an open symbol, immediately after that write a closed symbol and then go back inside to actually type the argument inside those open and closed symbols after the fact. In the next video, we're going to dive deeper into the MATLAB desktop. I'll see you there.